Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today I am going to teach you how can you install a database on your computer. Now many of you might be thinking that why exactly do I need to install database on my computer? There are two reasons for that. The first reason is I am getting a repetitive question on my channel where people say I have started my UiPath journey, I am doing good into RPA, but now I want to enhance my skill, what should I consider? So the answer to that question is that we can explore the part of the database, which is an integral part of the many automation. You would require database to insert the data, retrieve the records, maybe update the records, store the result intermittently or between any part of the automation. So that is the first part, that why do you install a database. The second thing is, if you have noticed that I have a dedicated playlist on creating the use cases, end-to-end use cases with UiPath. In future, I plan to create more use cases with integration between UiPath and the databases. So that is where we require to have the database installed on our computer. In case you don't understand what exactly is a database, how do we install the database, what are the prerequisites, don't worry, your all the question would be answered in this video. So let's get started of installing the database. So this is our agenda for today. We are going to start with the prerequisites. I'm going to tell you the difference between a SQL Server and the SQL Server Management Studio, which is also known as SSMS. Post that, I am going to install SQL Server Express Edition, and after that we will be installing the SSMS, and at the end of the video we are going to validate that yes, the installation is complete and proper. So let's get started by looking at the prerequisites. These are the prerequisites for installing a SQL Server 2019 version. These are the details which I have taken from the Microsoft website. I have put the links in the description for your reference in case you want to install any other version or any other variant, right? We can have a hard drive of 6 GB, a memory of 512 MB for the Express edition, and for the other edition it's 1 GB. The processor speed and the recommendation, everything is available here, right? So in case you want to know more, I have provided the list link in the description. Now these are the prerequisites. Now let's jump to how I can install and where I'll get the files to install. So for that, we'll come back to the browser, and in the browser, in the Google, I'll type install SQL Server. I have already typed it, so it's in my search. So I'll go here and I say install SQL Server. You'll scroll down and you will see the Microsoft site, which says microsoft.com, and the SQL Server download. If I click on this link, it will take me to the official website of Microsoft, and I have all the links to download the SQL Server, right? This direct link is also available in the description, so you can directly click there and navigate to this site as well, okay? Now, if I come down, you would see here there are a section which says download a free specialized edition, right? So these are the two SQL Server variant which Microsoft offers. One is the developer and the other one is the Express. Developer is a 2019 developer, full feature and a free edition, right? License for use of development, test database and the non-production environment. On the other hand, the Express is also a free edition of SQL Server, ideal for development, production for desktop, web and small server applications, right? So today in this tutorial, I am going to tell you how do I install the Express one, right? So I go here in this website and I click on this button which says download now. Once you click on the download now, the SQL 2019 Express Edition EXE would be downloaded on your computer, right? Now you have to simply double click on the EXE and it will show a prompt to install the SQL Server 2019. This wizard will get started and it will ask you that which kind of installation you want to proceed, right? So there are three type: basic, custom, and the download media. Download media simply means that I can download all the files, I'll download all the exes and keep it in my computer, and I can actually go and install at later point of time. Or this is also useful, let's say I want to download here and I want to install it in some different computer. The other option is the custom one, where you get to choose your installation setup. And the first one, and the pretty basic, is the basic one, which says the basic installation to install the SQL Server database with all the default configuration. So for this one, I am going to stick to the basic. Once I click on basic, I get the license terms and conditions. So you can read the license terms and condition. And at the end, you would have this button which says accept. So that means I am accepting the terms and condition. The next thing, it is asking me, where do you want to install the SQL Server? So for me, I want to install it in my C program file, SQL Server. You always has an option to change it to the some different drive, C drive, E drive, or F drive. This says that the minimum free space and the download size. This gives you the details, what exactly are the requirement. Once you are done with setting up the installation location, click on this button which says install, right? Now it will go and start acquiring the download files from the internet for the SQL Server 2019. So now this is the actual download happening for the SQL Server 2019 edition. It will download all the packages and then it will start the installation. So we just have to wait for the download to complete, and this is how the screen will look like. Once the download is successful, it will automatically start the installation. This might take around 6 to 7 minutes to get completed. Now, once it is completed, you just have to wait for this. Once the download and the install of the SQL Server 2019 is completed, you will get this screen, which will tell you that the installation has been completed successfully. It will give you all the details, that what is the SQL Server, this is the detail, this is my computer information. All the details would be available here, and which will specify that you have installed the SQL Server 2019 Express Edition. Once you are in this screen, the next thing which you have to do is install the SSMS. So at the bottom, you would see there are four buttons. You have to go to the third button, which says install SSMS, and click on this button. As soon as you click on that button, which says SSMS, it will take again back us to the Microsoft website and navigate to a page which says download SQL Server Management Studio, also known as the SSMS. So if you see here, it says to download the SSMS free version, click here. So free download of SQL Server Management Studio. So I click here and it will download the SQL Server Management Studio EXE for me, right? So once you click here, it will download the EXE and which you can install. Many of you watching this tutorial might have a question that previously you told us to install the SQL Server and now you are telling us to install the SSMS. I am new and I don't understand what is the difference between installing the SQL Server and installing this SSMS, right? So let me quickly answer that question for you. So this is a difference between a MS SQL Server, which we installed first, and the second part, which is the SQL Server Management Studio, right? The SQL Server is a relational database management system developed by Microsoft, whereas the SSMS is an environment for managing the SQL infrastructure. When I say SQL, I mean structured query language. So the Microsoft SQL Server is a database management and analysis system. It's a complete DBMS system where you can do all the database management. Whereas the Microsoft SQL Management Studio, also known as the SSMS, it provides you tools to configure, monitor the SQL Server and the databases. So basically, it will provide me an interface where I can actually go and configure, monitor, create the table, write the queries, and all of these things. Where I am going to use the SSMS, I am going to use it to deploy, monitor, upgrade the data tier components used by the application, as well as build queries and scripts. Next, the Microsoft SQL Server belong to the database categories, whereas the SSMS is primarily classified as the database tools. So this is a database category, Microsoft SQL Server, which we installed at the beginning. The later part, the SQL Server Management Studio, is a database tool. So you can think it like that, to work with the databases where we can create the table, create the stored procedure, build the queries, I require the SQL Server Management Studio. Okay, so I hope now you understand the difference between the SQL Server and the SQL Server Management Studio. Now that you understand what is the difference, so this web page has opened for you guys and we have clicked on this free download for this version. This would have downloaded an executable file in your downloads location and you can simply double click and install it. So this is how the installation wizard will look like. You simply have to click on the install button and you can change the default location. If you want to install it at some different location, I have already installed, so I have just put the screenshots here, right? So I go here and I simply click on this button which says install. Now we just have to wait for the installation to complete. It will take a couple of minutes. You just have to accept some terms and conditions if it appears and just hit next if it prompts. Otherwise, you will see these kind of screens getting populated on the screen. First loading the packages, package progress, and there would be an overall progress. So once this overall progress reaches to the end, you would see something like this, which says that Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio is installed on your computer. Once you are able to see the screen, this means that you have successfully installed the SSMS or the SQL Server Management Studio. Now, let's try to validate how exactly we can see that whether it is installed successfully or not. So for the validation, you have to come to the computer, go to the start menu and search here SSMS, which stands for SQL Server Management Studio. You would see something like this. Click on this button and that will open the SQL Server Management Studio for us, right? Let us just wait for the SQL Server Management Studio to fire up. Once it is loaded successfully, it will give me options to select the database, write the query, and do the next set of steps. Once the SSMS is successfully open, you would see something, a wizard like this, which says that connect to the server. So this is asking us which server do you want to connect. So typically this means that which database server you want to connect. By default, when you are starting it for the first time, you would have your laptop name here, which says this is my laptop number, this is the SQL Express and the Windows authentication. If I click on connect, it should connect to my database. But let's say for some of you, if this guy is coming as blank, what you can do is you can go to the server name in the dropdown. You would select browse for more. In the database engine, you would see the same thing, which is the laptop here, and you select OK. Now this will land you to the same screen. I'll keep this to the Windows authentication, which means that I'm telling it to use my current username and the password to connect to my SQL Express. So all I have to do is now click on connect. If I click on connect, you would see on the left hand side that I am connected to the SQL Express and all my database would be available on this side. As of now, I don't have any database, so it's absolutely blank. Now, if I want to disconnect, I can simply use this disconnect button and we can explore all of these things. Now, let's quickly validate if it is connected and working fine. So I go here to the new query and I'll simply write a statement here. Let's say select 100 plus 200. And click on this green button which says execute. And yes, I'm able to get the result of 300, which means that my SQL Server is installed and I'm able to get the results as well. What are the next step? The next steps are we can actually go and create the databases, write queries, create tables and all the bits, right? So congratulations, if you are following along with me, you have successfully installed the SQL Server Management Studio and now you are free to explore the databases. Okay, so let's quickly summarize what we covered today. So first of all, we have covered how I can do a step-by-step installation of the SQL Server and the SSMS. We have seen what is the difference and we have also seen what are the prerequisites. And at the end, we have also validated the installation. I hope you were able to follow along with me and able to complete the installation. All the links, everything showed in the video are available in the description for your reference. In the upcoming videos, we would be looking at how to get started with databases. We'll create some of the databases, write some of the queries, and then we'll try to connect this thing to the UiPath Studio. Okay, so that is all for this video. I would like to wrap this video here. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please do subscribe to the channel and happy automation.